Now, in the beginning of this unit, I did a little magic trick having to do with coloring in regions in a map. This problem is sometimes called map coloring. And just to remind you, the idea there is that each of the regions in the map, we're going to assign some color to it with the constraint that there can't be the same color in two adjacent regions on the map, because then it'll kind of make it look like one big region. We can actually think of this as a problem on graphs. In particular, we're going to make each region on the map correspond to a node in a graph, and we're going to connect two nodes of the graph if they share a border and therefore can't have the same color in the map. A shares borders with B and F. F shares borders with G, B, and A. B shares borders with A and F that we have already, and G and C. C shares borders with D and H. H shares a border with G and E and D. G, C, D, E. G, C, D, E. D and E share a border. Did I get everything? H doesn't connect to B. G doesn't connect to C. Yes, it does. G has borders with F, B, C, and H. So given that transformation, the equivalent graph coloring problem is going to be, given a graph G and some number K, can we assign each of the nodes in the graph a color, specifically some number between from 1 to K, so that neighbors in the graph have different colors, have different numbers assigned to them? Turns out this problem comes up a lot, not just in geography, but also in lots of computer science applications. For example, in compilers trying to figure out how to use the registers of the computer to solve or to evaluate expressions. And it also comes up in social network problems. You can imagine saying, okay, I've got a group of people, here's their friend network. What I'd like to do is group them into K different groups so that within each group, there's no pairwise friends. So you can think of this as building a mixer, right? Like a party where you want to invite your friends, but you want them to interact with people that they aren't already friends with.